Hello students, this is Dr. Nimulangshu here. So today we are going to solve some of the problems regarding nomenclature of coordination compounds. Now in my previous class we have seen there are certain rules to give name to a coordination complexes, likewise of organic chemistry, as you have studied in class 11. Now we have gone through certain rules that the cationic portion is named first, then followed by the anionic portion. Then ligands are named in alphabetic, if more than one type of ligands are present, then the ligands are named in alphabetical order. For example, if there are two ligands like amine and chlorido is present, then amine will come first. Then the prefixes like di, tri, tetra, hexa, penta, etc. are used to indicate the number of ligands. Now, no matter, one complex we have taken example, that CONH3-5Cl. Now, in that complex, since NH3 is of the number of 5, so we will write pentaamine. Then you can say that P will come after chlorido. No, the numbering will not create any problem in giving the name to the particular ligand. Okay. Next rule is that the oxygen state of the metal is indicated in Roman numeral immediately after the name of the metal. Then if the metal is an anionic one, if the central metal atom comes in the anionic portion of the complex, then the name of the metal will end in 8. The name of the metal will end in 8, and in that case what will happen? The Latin names of the metal is used. For example, lead will become plumbate, tin will become stannate, gold will become orate, silver will become argentate, copper will become cuprate, so and so on. Okay, zincate, cobaltate. So in this way, which I have also given in PDF form also in my previous class. So in this way, we are going to give the name to a particular coordination entity. Now next is that there should not be any space while giving the name of a particular coordination complex, because there should not be any space now in between, but a space should be maintained between the cationic and anionic portion. So so be careful while giving the name to a particular coordination complex, and it will definitely come in your final exam as well as your entrance exam. So be careful while giving the name. So let's solve some of the problems regarding the nomenclature. So let's see. So first we are going to take one complex, that is K4FeCN6. Now in this complex, the cationic, this portion is cationic one, this portion is cation and cationic, and this portion is anionic. This portion will come first, and the portion which is outside the coordination sphere, no need to indicate the number of atoms or groups of atoms coordinated to that coordination sphere. So since potassium is there in four number, so no need to give the number, so just we will write potassium, and then we will maintain one gap, and gap should be, space should be maintained. Then we will come to hexacyanido. How many cyanide are there? So 6 cyanide are, so hexacyanido. Then iron will become ferrite, and oxidation state of the metal is 4 into plus 1 plus x plus 6 into minus 1 is equal to 0, so x is equal to plus 2. So ferrite 2. So the name of the complex is potassium hexacyanido ferrite 2. Next complex we are going to take is another complex, that is K2PTCl6. So this portion is also an anionic complex, because the name of the metal will come in the anionic portion. So this portion is cationic. This portion is a cationic one, and this portion is anionic. Okay. While naming the cationic portion, so potassium is there. So no need to indicate a number of potassium coordinated. So we'll just write potassium. Then maintain one space. Then how many Cl is there as a ligand? 6 Cl are there. So hexachlorido, hexachlorido. Then now the platinum is in the secondary atom is platinum, which is in the anionic portion. So it will end in 8. So platinate, platinate, and the coordination number is the oxidation number is 4. Oxidation number is 4. How 4? See, potassium is 2 into plus 1 plus x plus 6 into minus 1 because Cl is minus 1. So x is equal to plus 4. Okay, in this way, these complexes will get the name. Next complex we are going to solve is another complex. So let's see what the complex is. Let's see what comes in our portion. So let's see what the name of the complex is. Next is CONH3 6Cl3. CO, third complex is CONH3 6. Then in outside the coordination sphere is Cl3. So no need to indicate the number of Cl attached to that coordination sphere. So in this way, in this one is the cationic portion, this one is the cationic one, and this portion is the anionic portion. So while giving the name, we will say that how many amines are there? 6 amines are there. So hexa amine. Now the metal will not end in 8 because it is in the cationic portion. So hexa amine cobalt. Now the oxygen state of the metal is 3. Oxygen state of the metal is 3. How 3? Is x plus 6 into 0 plus minus 3 is equal to 0. So x is coming out as plus 3. So hexa amine cobalt 3. And then we maintain our space because the cationic portion is finished here. And then we will write chloride. No need to indicate the number, how many chloride is there. So just we will write chloride. So in this way, these complexes will get the name. Next is another complex. PtNH3 2Cl4. Number 4 complex is PtNH3 2Cl4. PtNH3 2Cl4. So let's see, my dear students, here this complex is a neutral complex. This complex is a neutral complex because nothing is outside the coordination sphere. Everything is finished over here. So this complex is a neutral complex. So now we will indicate the number of ligands in the alphabetical order. So amine is there as a ligand and Cl is there as a ligand. So definitely amine will come first. So how many amine are there? So it will be diamine. Then how many chlorine is there? Tetrachloride. Platinum. Then platinum. Then the oxidation state of the metal. What is the oxidation state of the metal? So x plus 2 into 0 minus 4 is equal to 0. So x is equal to plus 4. So platinum 4. Okay. So that will come in Roman numeral, platinum 4. Okay. So this is, let's take another complex. The fifth one we are going to take. So there are so many examples in your NCERT book, and also I will provide you the notes of this chapter. So there are so many complexes in your, so many examples are there. You just go on solving, and if you find any problem, so feel free to ask me, because it is just like organic chemistry as you have studied in your class 11. The many you will solve, the more the concept will get clear. So just go on solving, just take examples from various sources, from NCERT books and various sources. Just go on solving. If you still find any problem in solving any of the complex, you are free to ask me. The next complex we are going to take is CONH3 3Cl3. Now the fifth one is CONH3 3. Then Cl3, then the coordination sphere is closed over here. So CONH3 3Cl3, so it is also a neutral complex. It is also a neutral complex. So what will be the name? So the metal atom metal atom will not ending it here. So amine is one of the ligand and Cl is another ligand. So triamine. How many amines are there? So triamine. Then how many chlorine is there? Trichloride. Then cobalt. So what is the oxidation number of this metal here? Cobalt is having 3 oxidation number. So cobalt 3. It will come in Roman numeral. So cobalt 3. Next complex is, we are going to solve another complex, is K3CONO26. K3, then CO, then NO26. K3CONO26. So it is an anionic complex because this is the cationic portion, this is the cationic portion, and this is the anionic portion. So this portion will come first. So potassium. So the name of this complex will be potassium. Potassium. Then space is maintained. Then how many NO2 is there? 6 NO2 is there. So hexanitro cobaltate, because the metal is in the anionic portion. Cobaltate. And what is the oxidation state of this metal? Is 3R. Okay. So potassium hexanitro cobaltate 3. Or also we can write potassium, I have said in the naming of ligand, hexanitrito, then coordination is through N. So hexanitrito N, cobaltic, hexanitrito N, then cobaltic 3. So in this way the coordination complex will get the name. So these are few examples which we have solved here today. Then another complex we are going to do is, if the complex is an ionic one, if the complex is ionic, we have seen that cationic, neutral or anionic complexes are there. Now let's see another type of complex, which is, that is we are going to see here, NiCl4 2 minus, NiCl4 2 minus. So this complex is an ionic complex. So how many chlorine is there? So tetrachloride, then nickel. It will not come in the it will not end in 8. So it will be tetrachloride nickel. Now since it is an anionic complex, so nickel 8, tetrachloride nickel 8. And what is the oxygen state of the metal? Oxygen state is X plus 4 into minus 1 is equal to, not 0 here, is equal to minus 2. So in neutral complexes, is equal, we give a summation of or algebraic sum of all the ligands including metal is equal to 0. But in case of ionic complex, whether cationic or anionic, so the algebraic sum will be equal to the charge of the complex. The algebraic sum is equal to the charge of the complex. So it will become x plus 4 into minus 1 is equal to 2. So that is x is equal to plus 2. So the name will be tetrachloride nickelate 2. It will come in Roman numeral. Okay. And then it is an ion. So you will write here. Ion. So tetrachloride nickelate 2 ion. Now next complex we are going to solve another complex, that is RuNH3 5 Cl, then Cl, then it is a plus 2. So Cl then plus 2. So it is a cationic complex. Now ligands are here. There are two types of ligands are present. One is amine and one is chloride. So the name will be pentaamine pentamine, then chloride will come, then ruthenium. This Ru, what is the name of Ru? Is ruthenium. Now what is the oxygen state of ruthenium here? Oxygen state of ruthenium is X plus 5 into 0 plus minus 1 is equal to plus 2, because I have said here in this complex that in case of nitrile complexes, the algebraic sum of the ligand and metal is will be equal to 0. But in case of ionic complex, the algebraic sum is equal to the charge of the complex. So be careful about this point. So the x is coming as x equal to plus 3. X equal to plus 3. So ruthenium then 3. And since it is an ion, so we will write here ion. Okay, pentamine, chloride, ruthenium, 3 ion. Next is another complex we are going to take, that is Fe. Now we are going to take complexes with bidentate ligand, with bidentate one. So FeN3, next complex we are going to take is Fe. So let's see, it is a very interesting complex. How we will name bidentate ligand containing complex? So FeEN3Cl3. So FeEN3, then coordination sphere, then Cl3. So this question is a cationic question, this question is an anionic question. So this one is cationic, so it will come first in the naming, and this question is anionic, this will come later on in the naming, and no need to indicate the number of Cl present here. So it will be, the name will be, now how many ethyl En is, what is the name of En? En is equal to ethylene diamine, that we have read in, that we have read while discussing naming of ligand. So ethylene diamine, be careful about amine. This amine, this M is single M, and in naming of ligand NH3, that is double M, amine, it is amine, okay. So En is ethylene diamine. So in the name of this ligand, we have this word di already here in this name. So we cannot use di. How many En is there? Tri. Tri-en is there. So 3 En is there. So we cannot say triethylene diamine. If I say triethylene diamine, the ligand will be a different one. It will no more be this ligand. So in that case, what we have said in my previous class, say that in that case we will use the prefixes like bis, tris, tetrakis, pentakis, hexakis, etc. So and so on. So how many ethyl diamine is there? So 3 ethyl diamine is there. So you will use this prefix tris ethylene diamine. Tris, then you give bracket ethylene diamine. So be careful, my dear students, while adding amine, because one amine is of NH3, which is acting as ligand. In that case, amine, the spelling of the amine is a double M-I-N-E, amine. But in this case, it is diamine, a single M-I-N-E. And this ligand, in the name itself, it contains this word di. So if we write triethylene diamine, 3 ethylene diamine is present here in this complex. So if we write triethylene diamine, it will no more be this ligand now. So for this type of ligands, where the words or where the prefixes di, tri, tetra is already there in the ligand name. So in that case, we will use the prefixes bis, tris, tetrakis, pentakis, hexakis, so and so on. So here we are using tris ethylene diamine. Then how many? Then iron. So it will not become ferrate, because it is in the cationic question. And what is the oxygen state of this metal? So ethylene diamine is a neutral ligand. So 3 into 0 plus 3 into minus 1 is equal to 0. So X is coming as X equal to plus 3. So iron 3, and then you will give one space and then chloride. Then you give a space and then chloride. Similarly, another complex, let's take another complex, anion, GLY, than 2. N-I-G-L-Y than 2. So what is the name of GLY? GLY is glycinator. GLY is equal to, GLY is equal to glycinator. Okay. So it is also a bidentate ligand. We have read already. Okay. So the name glycinator, in this case also we will use the prefixes like bis, tris, tetrakis, pentakis, hexakis, etc. So bis glycinator, how many glycinator is there? Bis, then we will give bracket, glycinator, bis glycinator, then we will give nickel, because it is in the cationic, it is in the neutral portion. So bis glycinator nickel, what is the oxidation state of this metal? So oxidation state is 2. Oxidation state is 2 because as you see here x plus 2 into minus 1 is equal to 0. So x is equal to 2. So because I have given the structure of glycinator in my previous class. So you see the structure of glycinator ligand. So here in glycinator we have at one side we have C double O minus and at one side we have NH2. So NH2 is a neutral one because it is donating through its lone pair, and in other side C double bond O minus, that portion it is donating through the minus portion. Okay. So the charge is minus 1, so x equal to plus 2. So x equal to plus 2. So bis glycinator nickel 2. Bis glycinator nickel 2. Next let us see another complex. Let's see what the complex is. So this one, again I am telling my dear students, please go on solving this nomenclature, because until unless you become expert in this nomenclature, you cannot attempt any question in your final exam. So let's take another example, CO Cl2, then En2, then potential sphere closed Cl. Now in this complex C, this is the cationic portion definitely. This is the cationic portion definitely, and this portion is the anionic one. This portion is the anionic one. So what will happen? So here two types of ligand is present. One is chlorochlorido and another one is ethylene diamine. Now in this complex, which one will come first? Chlorido will definitely come first because C comes before E. So how many chlorine is there? Two chlorine is there. So the name is dichlorido. Then how many N is there? Two N is there. Means two ethylene diamine ligands are there. So in that case, in this type of ligand, what we will do? Bis. We use the word bis. Dichlorido bis. Then ethylene diamine. Okay. Then we will write cobalt. So no space is there. Cobalt. Then we will give the oxidation state. Oxidation state is 3 here. Then one space is maintained here. Then chloride. Okay. So how 3C? Oxidation is X plus 2 into minus 1 plus ethylene diamine is a neutral ligand. So 2 into 0 plus minus 1 is equal to 0. So X is equal to plus 3. So the name is dichlorido bis ethylene diamine cobalt 3 chloride. So in this way, my dear students, you go on naming the coordination compound. In my next class, we are going to do the naming of polynuclear, means the coordination complex is there, but the two types of central metal atoms are there. Two types of central metal atoms containing coordination complex. So that are called polynuclear coordination complex, that we will discuss in my next class. And also there are complexes where a ligand acts as a bridge between two central metal atoms. So that complexes are called bridged complexes. Breached, that complexes are called breached complexes. So next class we will come with number 1 polynuclear coordination complex, means the coordination complex for polynuclear coordination complex means the coordination complex polynuclear complex means the coordination complex with more than one central metal atom. Coordination complex with more than one central metal atom is called polynuclear complex. And then we are coming with breached polynuclear complex. Breached polynuclear complex. Okay. Coordination complex. More precisely you can say coordination complex. So with this I want to end up my session here today. So again and again I am telling to you my dear students, please go through these rules and study the rules very carefully and solve as many problems as you can, because the more you solve, the more the concept will clear be. So don't hesitate to ask any question if you find any problem regarding solving of coordination complexes naming. So with this I want to end up my session here today. Thank you very much my dear students.